make sure you stick around until the end to see how you can win free gear and products. Hey, this is PJ with CLK Supplies. And today we're gonna be talking about the aluminum storefront doors, just like the ones you see right here, commonly also referred to as Adams Rite doors. Now, there's a couple big things that if you're new to working on and servicing these, that if you don't know, you're gonna find yourself in a whole bunch of trouble. And so my goal in this video is to help you avoid that. Let's go ahead and get started. Now, when you walk up to one of these doors, this is what you're gonna see as far as the lock goes. You're just gonna see if 2 to 3 different screws depending on what type of latch mechanism is here. Now, all of them are essentially work the same way as far as, you know, removing them and servicing them. So let's go ahead and let's get these 3 screws off here. Now, while I'm doing this, I just wanna point out, it's really important to remember that when these doors are put in, they're just, you know, put together, made to work, and that's kind of the end of it. And so a lot of times when a locksmith shows up or someone who's supposed to be working on this door, especially the lock, things might not be perfect. And that is kind of to be expected. And you'll see why here in a few minutes. So once you get all these 3 screws out here, you essentially just gotta get this plate off. And let me just see if I can pop it with this screwdriver. There we go. And we'll get this plate off here. Now it was pretty tight on there, and this is a new door, and you can kind of see this thing is beat pretty well. Quite impressive. All right, now once you get the cover plate off here, is what you're really gonna be looking at is this right here. And you can see, is this, this is Adams Rite unit right here. And you're gonna see these 2 set screws right here. These set screws are what hold the cylinders in place. Now I went ahead and I grabbed the same exact one that we're looking at here, and I just wanted to show you what you're looking at on the inside. So it's this set screw that's actually holding this cylinder into place. All right, and why I really want to show you this is for 2 reasons. One is the amount of threads that we're looking at here. Let me count them. 1, 2, 3. Looks like about 4. There's about 4 threads in here. So 4 threads are holding this mortise cylinder into this actual lock housing. And I'll get into why that's important in just a moment. But the other thing I wanted to show you was actually how frail these things are as far as like what holds them together. So you take this set screw, which is this right here, and when it's in the lock, all this set screw is sitting right in this groove right here. That's it. So let me turn it around so you can see. So this set screw in this groove, that's actually what is holding this lock tight in place. That is it. It's quite little when you think about it. Now, the reason I bring all this up when it comes to the threads, you know, there's 4 or 5 of them, and the threads on the cylinder, is because if you are not gentle, you're going to strip out the cylinder or the lock threads, or maybe both. And so the main point of this video I want to go over is how you can get this cylinder out of the door and replace it damage free. Now, I'll even pull up a picture right now of the first door I ever did when I was 15 years old as a locksmith for my dad. And the door was a nightmare. Now, I didn't know all of this, the stuff I know today when I was doing it. And I was at that job for 3-4 hours, and the customer was super, super unhappy to the point where he even called in and complained about me because I just couldn't get it. And the problem was exactly what I'm going to go over today. All right, so let's go ahead and let's dive in. So to get this cylinder out, to either rekey it or replace it, is what you need to do is just loosen up this screw right here. Now just take it back for, you know, 3-4 turns. You don't want to take it all the way out, just leave it right there. And then it's what you want to do is you can stick in a blank key. This is a Y1. I'm going to just stick a blank key in, or you can even use the actual key to it, but only keep it in about halfway. Now once you do that, this is where when you start to you know, counterclockwise unscrew this lock out of the door, this is what you need to really pay attention to. Okay, and I'll start doing it, and let's see. It's kind of hard to see, but you want to make sure that there's no tension when you're unwinding it here, that there's no tension. And where the tension's going to come from is going to be the angle of this lock in this into the hole here. So as what's happening is, you know, you're going to be grinding it through. Now, if you're not too familiar, on the back of these locks, there's the screws, right? These two screws right here. And there's springs behind them, and so they're held in by spring tension. All right, so this one you can see it's put in there pretty well. And so is what you want to do, if you're getting any resistance at all putting this in or taking it out, is you want to be messing with these screws here. Now, don't go crazy on them, just go a little bit at a time, and you just want to make sure that it's really smooth. As you can see, I mean, that's super, super loose, which is perfect, which means that the lock here is aligned, or the latch, I should say, is aligned with the door, or the hole in the door, which allows this to spin freely. That's what you want to pay attention to. So the one that I was telling you about, my first one I ever did, that the customer called and complained, it was a bad deal, okay? I mean, that's what, 20 years ago, and I still remember it like it was yesterday. Not fun. But the problem was is that this was so unaligned with the hole where the cylinder was that I could not get it out all the way. And then when I finally did get it out, I had stripped out both the lock and the cylinder. Now, of course, after looking at it, I could tell that it was, you know, the damage I had at least started before I even got there. And why this is so important is that there's going to be a lot of damage that you're going to encounter that's happened before you get there. So let me go ahead and take out this Adams Wright cylinder here, this Mortise cylinder, I should say, and I want to show it to you. So this is brand new, and as you can see here, there's only a few threads left. Now, whenever you possibly can, get rid of these cheap die-cast cylinders and replace them with like a GMS or Ilco solid brass Mortise cylinder, okay? So these, you don't want to be messing around with these things. They're not fun to rekey, and they'll strip really easy. But the point I'm trying to make here is that there's only a couple threads on the actual latch that you're screwing into, and it's only going to be touching a couple of these. So if you mess them up, or you show up to a job where they're already slightly damaged, well, guess what? You're not going to be able to get this back together. And that's what you want to avoid. And the first sign is going to be when you start to remove it from the door, is that tension. So remove the tension, okay? And then is what you'll do at that point is we'll go ahead and we'll put it back in here. And let's go ahead and take one of these nicer cylinders and put it on. Now, this is the key that works it right here. It's another Y1. This is a brand new cylinder, okay? And a lot of times, just take it out like that, and that's how you're gonna wanna screw it in the door, is just like this, okay? I'm gonna put that down, and then I'm gonna grab the beauty ring that came on the stock cylinder and put it on this one. We'll go ahead and get it put back in here, okay? Now, I prefer to, if at all possible, to not start with the key though, and we'll put the key in there in a minute. And the reason is when I get this put in here, okay, I wanna feel it, because of how few of threads we're working with, we do not want to strip it out at all, okay? So what I like to do is I like to put it in, and I like to just run it counterclockwise, which is the way to unscrew it, and that way it'll help get it aligned. Now, once you start doing that a little bit, okay, then I'm going to start working it back the other way here. Let's see, let's get it in here. There we go, okay? So I was just messing with just a very little bit of that thread, trying to get it perfectly aligned into the door here and into that latch. Now, once you have that, that's when you're gonna wanna put your key that works. You're only gonna put it in about halfway. And then at that point, you can use it to put it all the way back in. Just like that. Now, so what you wanna do here is just pretty much go till it stops, okay? And as you can see, that's not gonna work that way, so we're gonna just back it down, and we want it straight up and down, just like that. It's not going to work, and you're not going to hit the little side part here that we're gonna put that Allen screw into to hold it into place, all right? So you wanna make sure it's nice and straight up and down, just like that. And then we'll go ahead and we'll tighten it up on the set screw here. once we have that set screw tight, we can go ahead and put the key in all the way and give it a try. Just like that. So that's how it's gonna work there. So the only thing we have left to do now is to put the cover plate back on and we're done. So I really hope this video was helpful if you're new into working on this style of door. At the end of the day, is what you really need to remember is you only have a few threads you're working with. And so you really, really wanna make sure that you're not gonna strip them out at all, and to keep an eye out for when you show up to a job that the person before you has actually either done a lot of damage to those threads, and you don't wanna find yourself in a place where I'm at 3 hours in, calling the boss, complaining because I can't figure it out. I mean, I was probably sitting there looking at the door confused and nervous, and that's just the way life works sometimes. So I hope this is helpful. Please put your questions in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. I'm guessing if you just watched this video that you work with locks and keys. And to us here at CLK Supplies, that makes you a lock boss. And we wanna hook you up. Here's how it works. Throughout the week, we post videos on YouTube, like the one you just watched. And all you need to do is comment on the videos and include the hashtag LockBoss. When you do this, you're automatically entered in to win one of 5 free prizes that we give out each and every week. No purchase necessary. So if you're a lock boss, join us each week to learn, grow, and win.